Okay, so I figured out what I want to do with the channel over the next couple of months while we wait for the biggest year of Pokemon ever. The Pokemon 25th anniversary is shaping up to be something special, so much so that the corporate website, the Pokemon Company, has changed their slogan to connecting the real world and the virtual world. And we've already seen that with some of the crazy announcements earlier this year as we transition into the 25th anniversary, and it's only going to get more insane. So what I want to do with the channel as we wait for this announcement is just build up hype. The entire focus of this channel, what started off this channel, is my passion for Pokemon. Almost every video on this channel is a discussion I would have had about Pokemon anyways. It would have been either with friends or maybe the locals down at the card shop at the end of every week as we catch up with Pokemon news, or if I really had to say something, I would just post it on some kind of online forum because that's how people get their opinions out there. So what I want to do is I really want to capture my excitement for the 25th Pokemon anniversary. This has, like, I just don't know what to expect, but you know it's going to be good. And also, we're kind of like a year removed from this kind of discussion. That's because of Pokemon Sword and Shield. It's been 2 years since we've had these kind of, since we've had freedom to talk about the new Pokemon game, because the expansion pass was announced so early. We had November 2019, Pokemon Sword and Shield comes out. There's a lot going on in that game, so by the time January rolled around, boom, expansion pass. It was even before the anniversary of Pokemon, so we didn't have any time, and then everything's like, well, it's just going to branch upon Pokemon Sword and Shield, and we also knew what was going on. There was going to be a part in the middle of the year, and there was going to be a part later in the year, and that was it. Now, that had its own speculation. Were we going to get, you know, 20, 30 new Pokemon? That turned out to not be the case, but it was fun to dream back in the day, so that's what I want. I want non-stop discussion and hype about the future of Pokemon, and if you enjoy that idea, don't forget to leave a like and share this video with all your friends. If they've been interested in Pokemon at all, let's get them on board for the Pokemon 25th anniversary. So yeah, after that long intro, we can finally get into what the video is about, but what do we have for the 25th anniversary being the year we finally have the all-region Pokemon game? Well, we have all of the starter Pokemon being represented in the only promotional information we have about this, the random Pokemon tweet, train on, logo, Pokemon 25, all that cool stuff going on, staying tuned for more details, but it's a celebration of all the starters, so they are keeping the history of Pokemon intact, but, I mean, we've already seen this before. Pokemon 20th anniversary, here was the logo. Also, it's kind of crazy to think that we got 6 more starter Pokemon, 2 generations, crammed in here after just 5 years. Now, there is one thing I want to clear up. There are people talking about how the logos for the 20th anniversary and the 25th anniversary are different. But no, there was actually the same exact logo as this, with a 0 instead of a 5. So this doesn't really mean anything. It's like, as the 25th anniversary evolves, as we get more information about it, when it becomes more relevant, then we're probably going to see like different logos and different ways that's represented. But this doesn't really mean anything. You can also see what happened with the event distributions. That was the year of mythical Pokemon. Is this going to be the thing that Game Freak does? Every 5 years, we're just going to get all the mythical Pokemon again, but at the very least, this represents all of the regions up until that time, which I think is pretty significant. That's what an anniversary is. It's the celebration of everything up until that point. But the difference between the 20th anniversary and the 25th anniversary is that on the 20th anniversary of Pokemon, we got the announcement of Pokemon Sun and Moon. So that was the big deal, a new generation of Pokemon, a new main series Pokemon game. 25th anniversary, we don't have that because we just had Pokemon Sword and Shield. It is way too early. We're not going to see a new generation Pokemon after just 2 years. Also, when it came to the 3DS, that was a very underpowered system when it came out, and it was struggling by the time Pokemon Sun and Moon and Pokemon Ultra Sun Ultra Moon came out. So the Nintendo Switch itself affords us a lot more room to play with, and we've already seen Pokemon or the Pokemon Company take advantage of that with Pokemon Home. That this is a place where Pokemon can gather, and there's also a lot of interconnectivity, that we've already had the implementation of Pokemon Go. So we have Pokemon Go, Pokemon Bank, Pokemon Let's Go Pikachu and Eevee, Pokemon Sword and Shield, and you know, as more and more games come out, this is just going to get filled in with more and more compatibility, and that's really it. The question is, how far into the future does Pokemon Home work? Is this until we get like maybe two more generations of consoles? And since it deals with smartphones, I think it's going to be a pretty stable system for a while. So yeah, you just keep updating Pokemon Home. You just keep on changing what Pokemon Home is, and that's going to keep everything all nice and packed together. Also, I was like kind of just having some fun going through this, kind of seeing what happened with the announcement, because we had this information about the website before Pokemon Home even came out. So kind of got an idea of how it's going to work together, but just kind of the same stuff that we've been experiencing. Room, battle data, Pokemon Home points, just general Pokemon Bank stuff. What I like about Pokemon Home is how well it works with all of those games. You just, you know, connect Pokemon Go, you're in, you open up your Nintendo Switch, and then you can choose from all of your games. So if there was a Pokemon game that had all of the generations on it, or like a multi-region Pokemon game, then yeah, it's actually going to work really nicely with Pokemon Home, and that would really bring everything about Pokemon together. So I think in that way, we do have that possibility. I just don't think we have too much to go off of with the representation, and also just the general limited amount of information, which is effectively no information, that we have about the 25th anniversary. It's really this, and then the accidentally leaked Pokemon pack seeded Chimchar promo about the 25th anniversary. So we know there's going to be a set that has 25 Pokemon for all of the starters plus Pikachu for the TCG, and then we're just kind of waiting for that promo to kind of come together. So that's going to be happening on February 19th, 2021. So we have these little bits of extra things that are kind of just tying everything in Pokemon together as we move forward into the future, which is really cool. So it's kind of having this as a stable platform, especially when we're thinking about the 25th anniversary of Pokemon, it would just be super awesome. It's like, okay, we just have everything. You start from here in a modern sense. You have effectively all the games in a short amount of time that interact together and work together inside of Pokemon Home, and then you just kind of carry it through, and then it's going to be a lot easier for Game Freak and the Pokemon Company to manage everything as it goes into the future as well. We've kind of also seen with the Virtual Console on the 3DS, with Pokemon Blue version, Pokemon Silver version, those games being able to modernize into Pokemon. That was kind of a big deal because you can't transfer from the Game Boy into the Game Boy Advance and then move that Pokemon into Pokemon Bank and then Pokemon Home. And even then, going from Game Boy Advance to Pokemon Home, that is quite the chore, and not everyone, most people even, don't have access to that. So just kind of having this place where Pokemon can gather as the base point is going to be a really good idea for Pokemon. And yeah, the 25th anniversary I think is significant enough to warrant that. My problem is, I don't know how you can balance an all regions Pokemon game. We kind of saw with the Isle of Armor that we were able to add effectively two other regions to a game, but people weren't happy about it. They're like, oh, the level scaling just isn't that great. You know, they said they'd be able to scale with your level, but the Pokemon still cap at like level 60 to 70 or something, and then it's still super easy and it's not fun. Or even like scaling to where you are in the game. You'd be very early on in Pokemon Sword and Shield, and then everything in the Isle of Armor is just going to be lower in that regard. The Crown Tundra did take this a step further, but it still wasn't as far as people wanted it. That creates a major problem for an all-region Pokemon game, or even a multi-region Pokemon game. And once you make it to a certain point, it's like, well, I'm just going to be level 100 in everything by the time I finish the Hoenn region. So it's just going to be low 100s versus low 100s, and everything just kind of feels battle towery and too even. You know, one of the ideas or one of the strategies in Pokemon is just over leveling, and then you're able to power through a lot easier. Now people do kind of complain about that, but that is a part of the game. You grind, and then you use that to kind of get through some of the tougher parts inside the game. If everything is level 50 or level 100, or has like some kind of level scaling to it, as we saw in the Crown Tundra and the Isle of Armor, it's just not, it's not going to scale for another three regions after that or something. And also, when I'm thinking about an all-region Pokemon game, I'm thinking about just the first five. But then that's going to upset people. It's like, wait a second, you know, we can go to the first five regions, but then what about Kalos? And if we're getting a Sinnoh remake, that means we're revisiting Sinnoh again really soon. And then we're also, Alola region's kind of new, but also kind of not new, but it'd be weird if we couldn't visit it arbitrarily. Also, Kalos didn't really get that third version that everyone wanted, or, you know, the sequel versions. So how are we going to get that expanse? That's missing out. Now we gotta wait for the Generation 6 remakes, and all that stuff, and just feels like a big old mess. So my general thoughts about an all-region Pokemon game is that it probably isn't going to work or really feel that good for many different reasons. I mean, like I said, we effectively have three regions in Pokemon Sword and Shield, and that's starting to feel close to the limit. Like, if I could go to every Pokemon game, it would have to be like an online MMO. It would have to be a PC game. It couldn't be some kind of single player thing where I'm getting lost and just neglecting regions and neglecting areas and neglecting all this work the developers put into the game. And then there's really, unless there's like crazy incentives, but there's not even that many Pokemon. There's not enough incentives in Pokemon to make an all regions Pokemon game exist like that. And if you're only getting like picking and choosing one or two, then there was really no point for an all-region Pokemon game to begin with. And even though I love some of the features in the older Pokemon games, I don't need them all in one place, and I certainly don't need them in every single game. We saw this with Pokemon Sword and Shield. Pokemon Sword and Shield with the DLC brought back Pokemon Following You, but it didn't feel nearly as good as it felt when it first happened in HeartGold SoulSilver. That was a very integral part of the game, and even with Pokemon Let's Go Pikachu and Eevee, it felt right. Forcing it into Pokemon Sun and Moon, or Pokemon Ultra Sun Ultra Moon, or just having it in every 3D Pokemon game, that wouldn't work, and it would have worn off really quickly. And we even see with Pokemon Sword and Shield, it's like, they just kind of slapped it in, and yeah, we just don't need an older feature that was really well done slapped into a newer game because that's what people want, or, you know, people don't want anything removed. No, I think it's actually worth having value in those features. I can wait until the Sinnoh remake for the Underground to return, and then it would be the greatest thing ever. But one thing to note is how the Underground followed up on the Secret Bases. It didn't completely copy it, it took the idea and made it even better with the new technology. So that's what I'd like to see. I'd like to see that expansion on it instead of just Underground, 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 and then people don't really care about it. With Omega Ruby and Alpha Sapphire, with those remakes, Secret Bases came back, they were better than ever, they were super updated, and they were really cool. And I put a significant amount of time into making guides about Secret Bases and also just making Secret Bases for myself. I loved it, and that's going to make me appreciate it even more when we finally get the Underground, and we also see other features in other Pokemon games. The Wild Area, open world exploration for the first time in Pokemon, that's what makes Pokemon Sword and Shield so special. But having all of those, or like all the features of all the different games, crammed into one game, I feel like it would take away from the highs of all, like it would just kind of level everything out. Like it'd be pretty awesome if I could bounce from the Underground into the Pokéathlon, but I wouldn't appreciate each of them individually because I would be so overwhelmed. Now I would love to see other features that have been removed make a return, like the Pokéathlon, like the Safari Zone that you could customize and get different Pokemon to appear, but once again, that being in like every game would be kind of weird. So the Pokemon Company, they just focus on taking these really cool ideas from the past and then modernizing them in a really engaging way. So that's kind of how I stand on that. It's like, yeah, all region would be cool to have all the features, but I can wait for the games to come out and introduce them naturally, or newer Pokemon games and generations to make them even better than they were. That's cool. So my main thought is, I wanted it, but I don't want any more. I do not want an all-regions Pokemon game, and I don't really think there's enough to suggest that's what we're going to be getting. I think where we should be looking is a Pokemon remaster collection, but even then, that's going to cap out around Generation 5. You know, you just have all of the 2D games ported into the Nintendo Switch, 3DS isn't too far removed at this point, and then that still creates that nice, solid ground that makes a lot of sense for the 25th anniversary. But talking about remaster, that's its own discussion. And I'm going to have that discussion on this channel, so subscribe if you enjoy all this Pokemon hype, hit that notification bell, and maybe you'll actually see my videos or something. But going back to just the not wanting an all-regions Pokemon game, that dream died for me after Generation 4. Like, Generation 5, before I knew that Black and White sucked, before those atrocities tainted Pokemon, so like right after Pokemon HeartGold SoulSilver, I was thinking, if the new Pokemon game cycled back through all the generations, like we saw with Generation 2, which is what makes Generation 2 loved by so many fans, because even though you kind of like pop into the Kanto region and you're already overpowered and stuff, there was still some incentive, there was still some challenge there to where you just explore in your own way, get all the badges, and then, oh hey, Mount Silver unlocks, and then there's crazy high level Pokemon, and there's crazy in-game challenges there. But yeah, it's like, yeah, you could probably get two, maybe three regions before everything gets hard capped out and that's not fun anymore. So I'm thinking, all right, we take that into Generation 5, and then that would be the ultimate Pokemon experience. And it probably would have been just barely not too much, or maybe the right amount of too much. You know, you can get a little too overburdened, but make it still manageable. However, at this point, it's like, if I have to do something Unova, I'm not going to like it. If I have to go back to Kalos, I'm like, sure, that's cool, but then the Alola region, that was so recent. And I mean, like, where do we draw the line? But then that's going to upset people, and it's just too much for me. I don't want to see that all-region Pokemon game, unless it is, like, something that is actively updated, multiplayer, online, always connected, because then you're just bouncing around, and you're actually in the Pokemon world. Like, an official Pokemon world MMO, but I don't even see that as a thing for at least a long time. Like, that'd be really awesome to see from Pokemon, and that's why I really like Pokemon Unite. Another discussion I plan on having is just, like, what that Pokemon Unite, that Tencent partnership, branching out into different genres, like a MOBA from Pokemon, after we've seen this expansion into the mobile markets, PC is in the cards. I'm not saying it's on the way, I'm not saying it's gonna happen, but now it's definitely a possibility, so I think that's where that game needs to go. So when it comes to the 25th anniversary, I've been saying this for the last couple of videos, but it's like, we still don't know enough. But that keeps me just, I'm just as much excited. Because it's like, yeah, this is going to be big. I already love the direction the Pokemon Company has been going in over the last couple of years. Pokemon Let's Go, amazing. Pokemon Sword and Shield, amazing. Now that we have DLC, that kind of just stacks more onto the anything is possible thing. So now, 3 months, less than 3 months. Just wait for that. And that's why I want to talk about it. Just kind of thinking like, oh, this would be cool, you know, as a possibility. Or not even for the 25th, but the future of Pokemon. What can Pokemon do beyond this, that's still something awesome and something that's worth talking about. But at the end of the day, I don't think the starter Pokemon are really that significant, because like I said, with a remaster, there's probably a cap, but you still have to represent everything on the 25th anniversary, so that's going to be a thing. I don't know how much we're going to get spoiled on the mythical Pokemon. The set just kind of means everyone's going to be happy about Pokemon in some kind of way, but that doesn't mean we have to be getting a remaster or a multi-region Pokemon game to get that same kind of 25th anniversary level thing that still honors everything about Pokemon to this point. So guys, enjoy the video. Hope you all have a nice day. Thank you very much for watching.